This is the MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show, the station that pays.
This is MC Reggie Fresh from the MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show. And folks, guess who's in the building? He was born in Jamaica, but grew up in South Florida. He went to American High School, got his bachelor at Florida International, and his master's degree at Florida Atlantic. And he's currently working on his doctorate degree. And he's also the author of a 5-star must-read book called Let's Get Married and Do Everything Except Make It Last. This book aims to undo many of misleading concepts used to historically prop up patriarchal beliefs by addressing the roles of religion, economics, politics, socialization, and the interpersonal development of men and women. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Mr. Adrian Carter.
Look, I live the life I deserve. Bless. A vacay, I feel better at work. I mean, whatever it's worth, I give whatever I'm worth. For my nigga, who gon' go to hell and back for me? I'ma give him heaven on earth for a hell of a check, yeah, whichever come first. Blessings on blessings on blessings. Look at my life, man, that's lessons on lessons on lessons. I treat the beat like it's a reverend. I tell the truth like Father forgive.
This is the MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show, a station that pays.
Like confetti, and then when you back, they back to call you dog. That shit can get petty. Don't get no dap to me now. Funny thing about talking behind my back is that...
Welcome to the MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show. What's going on, brother Adrian?
Man, thank you for having me on your show, man. It's an honor. Blessed. Doing well.
Not a problem. The first question we're going to talk about, man, the first question I'm going to ask you is, what made you want to become a book author?
Well, you know, I've been writing... You know, since I was 9 years old, I wrote my first poem in the third grade. Teachers are the meanest creatures. Mr. Branson made me very upset, told me I had to sit down and I couldn't say anything.
Right.
And the only thing I was left to do was just to write. So to now be where I am, you know, 30 years later, as an author, it's a passion of mine. You know, and, you know, for example, the opportunity to be on your show, to be having this conversation with you is amazing. I'm very appreciative of it because it gives me an opportunity to let other people know about the book.
Yes,
and
sir.
Hopefully be able to help people as they are continuing to develop and grow as people. And how do we love and how do we work through relationships and what does it mean to be a man in the 21st century? And how are we looking at relationships that have evolved from the traditional notion that we're used to where we are now. So I think it's very important work. It's a very important conversation. And the motivation of my personal experience from being married for 9 years and going through what I went through in the divorce process made this book very important for me to write.
Exactly.
So I'm just motivated and passionate about the topic.
Okay. Now, yeah. Now, anybody in this field who want to write, just like you were saying earlier about helping others, can you give them some advice? Because like I say, man, it's hard to be a writer and write a book, especially with a lot of pages, and get it, you know, out there so people can buy it. So what kind of advice do you have for the new upcoming authors and stuff like that?
Well, you know, what I've been discovering, Reggie, is you have kind of like a situation of two type of people out there.
Mm-hmm.
You have people who want to write a book because they think it's cool to say that they're an author.
Okay.
So they're really doing it for resume purposes, and they're trying to be able to say and share and as something that they've accomplished. I'm not going to say that anything is necessarily wrong with having goals and accomplishing something.
But it's got to be in your heart.
But specifically, say that again.
Got to be in your heart is what you're basically saying.
Right. Because the other type of people is have something to really say, right? It's have something to really say that you feel is dynamic enough that is going to change the world and change the people around you. And it has to be something that's being said in a unique enough way or unique enough perspective that's not already being said, right? Because sometimes if you're not careful, you could just be writing another book of the same kind of book that's already been written.
Exactly.
And maybe in some way or the other, we're all doing that, but it has to have a refresh perspective on it. What to me is a little disappointing or is a little underwhelming, I'll say, are people who are writing because they want to build their resume to say that they have a book. But I'm more applauding of the people who really have something to say, who are really trying to be a game changer. And that cuts across the board for different types of people, whether you're different types of writers. If you're writing nonfiction, you gotta really have something to say.
Gotcha. Now, what I want to do now, brother Carter, I want to talk about your book and give me some stuff that goes on in this book and the name of the book, so we can get it out there for everybody to buy.
Yeah, the name of the book is "Let's Get Married and Do Everything Except Make It Last: A Heart to Heart with Men on Loving and Leading." I'll say it again. The name of the book is "Let's Get Married and Do Everything Except Make It Last: A Heart to Heart with Men on Loving and Leading." I was married for 9 years, and to someone who I was deeply in love with, and it didn't work out. We came away with 3 children, which I'm excited about,
right,
and I'm grateful for.
Right.
But while going through the divorce process and while being married, there were so many things that were going on,
mm-hmm.
and I felt that the world shunned me, and when I say the world, the people in my space, shunned me with an expectation of what it meant to be a man in a way that I felt that was very lopsided and not fully taken into consideration who I was as a man, my emotions, my feelings. It was kind of like, be a man and man up. And I felt that it was very unbalanced. And I'm trying to say to the people in my space, like, hey, listen, man, this is a whole other adult in this situation who's clearly not being held accountable because of this idea of what it means to be a man and what it means to be a leader and to be a head. And I found the experience just very, very unfair and very dismissive of who I was at a deeper level.
Right. Man, let me ask you this, Brother Adrian. How can people purchase this book? Where are you? What's your social contacts and all that? Can you give me all that social media for everybody to listen to?
Yeah, it's available on goodreads.com. It's also available on Amazon. Please get the book. And please leave a review, especially with it being a new book like this. Reviews are very important so that other people know that you like the book and you found the book useful. You could also go to my website at www.amazon.com. Go to my website, which is www.adriancarterspeaks.com, and that would take you over to amazon.com if need be. Or again, you could go to goodreads.com and put in my name. So just also, you can follow me on social media and also get my book information at Adrian Carter Speaks.
Okay.
That's on Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn.
All right, cool. Now, how much does it cost to purchase it?
Oh, the book is like right under $17.
All right, cool. That'll work, man. Appreciate you being on my show, man. It was a privilege for you to be on here. And do you got any shout-outs for anybody?
Now, I definitely want to thank my publisher, Audrey Ori, along with Cammie Tappan, who worked on my book through their company, or through Audrey's company called 13th and Joan, program that they ran, 100 Seeds of Promise. I definitely want to thank my father, Dudley Carter, who has just been a phenomenal, inspirational help you know, just very motivational and supportive as I've gone through this book. And there's a whole heap of people, but I definitely just want to shout those folks out and say, tell them I appreciate them.
All right, man. That's great, brother. That is very great, man. And again, thank you for being on my show, man. I like what you got going on. I'm definitely going to purchase one of your books and spread the word to everybody else.
I appreciate that, man. That's what we want, man. 1 million copies sold.
That's right. That's right. And the last question I want to ask you, Brother Adrian, could you please tell the whole world out there what's the baddest station in the land and the station that pays?
Oh, ain't nobody else but the MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show.
And there y'all have it, folks. The book writer, 5-star, coming to you from Florida. He goes by the name of Adrian Carter. He was right here on the MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show.
This is the MC Reggie Fresh Morning Show. A station that pays.